We at In Samachar salute the bravery of our soldiers who are sacrificing their tomorrow for our today. Namaste India, I'm Deepak Butola and here's the latest update from across the border. The Chinese troops had moved back some distance following local commander level talks but had refused to remove these structures. At patrolling point 17, China had apparently raised objection to some Indian hutments. In the recent past, sources said that the Chinese troops have acted in a pattern where they move up, build tented structure and then move back after talks without demolishing what they had made. This was flagged off by the army as a way to make reoccupation easier at these heights. However, pending resolution of these issues on Galwan, China was keen to start conversation on areas of Pangong Tso. The first sign of discomfort in the Indian camp started when the Chinese side a few days ago began pressing hard for another round of Corps Commander level meeting to kickstart talks on the Pangong Tso. The PLA even moved a request for a Corps Commander level meeting on June 16. The Indian side, however, declined and had conveyed to their Chinese interlocutors that a higher level meeting would only be possible after complete disengagement from Galwan. The issue on the table from an Indian standpoint was two semi-permanent structures with tents on patrolling point 14 in Galwan. Prime Minister Modi on Wednesday said that the supreme sacrifice made by the Indian soldiers during the clashes at the China border won't go in vain. In a brief address to the nation, the PM reassured saying that the sacrifice of our Jawans will not be in vain. For us, the unity and sovereignty of the country is the most important. India wants peace, but it is capable of giving a befitting reply if instigated. The government has given powers to the armed forces to make emergency procurements to stock up its war reserves in the wake of the escalating conflict with China along the LAC. Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat has been asked to coordinate with the three services on prioritizing the requirements where necessary. The Navy and Air Force have also been given a go-ahead to deploy assets to move up to the strategic forward locations. That is all for now. For more news, please log into insamachar.com. Take care, India. Jai Hind.